the living God. Thank you for joining me today on Holy Ghost Fire Talk. I'm your host, Evangelist King, delivering pastor at House Shalom. Now, remember House Shalom now. We're simply building a peaceful house for God's glory. You know, paranormal investigators, psychics, they really teach us people it's okay to dwell with demons in their house. But dear heart, not so in God's house. He refused to dwell with demons in his house. Remember, our body is God's house. Our body is his temple, his tabernacle, his dwelling place. And he's not going to dwell with demons in his house. Meaning, the Holy Spirit is not going to be living in our spirit while the devil is raging hell in our soul realm, which is our mind, our will, and our emotion, also in our body. No. Now, Jesus once told me, said, Terry, I have some of you, but I don't have all of you. Praise God, he led me to my human helper, a female exorcist, just a child of God who happened to be a female who cast out devils. That's what an exorcist is, cast out devils. And God has delegated, given that thought to his body on earth. And God set me free. Now he has the whole house. So here at House Shalom, we teach you to be aware of who you allow into God's house, which is your body. Praise God. Again, thank you for joining in to Holy Ghost Fire Talk. This is a live broadcast. Comes on Mondays and Fridays at 12 noon Eastern Standard Time. If you want to join the host, just go to the website, thechildrenlight.org/radio, and you find instructions on how to commit with the host. Okay? On Holy Ghost Fire Talk, I do a light teaching of the Word of God. Afterwards, those who tune in, call in the dial-in number to join the host, you know, I will unmute you to see if you have any questions only pertaining to the message I bring you on. So today's message is entitled Treasure in Earthen Vessels. Now, I'm coming from 2 Corinthians, the 4th chapter. Earthen vessels, that means we, our body. The Holy Ghost in us, the heart, we are full of treasure. We are awesome. God in us, the hope of glory. So verse 1 says, therefore, seeing we have this ministry. And what is this ministry? Well, the Apostle Paul is here to tell us, as we have received mercy, we faint not. You know, mercy is a ministry. We have a ministry of mercy. Just like the Lord give us mercy, we should give others mercy. So therefore, we should not faint. We should not grow weary in well-doing. But God has given us this ministry of mercy. We have received mercy. So we faint not, regardless of what we go through. I know sometimes it seems so overwhelming that we're going to faint. No, we have to look at the greater one on the inside of us, the Holy Spirit. When we look on him, we will faint not. I have many occasions to faint. I remember the very first time. Actually, it's faint, F-A-I-N-T. Is actually a demonic spirit. And I remember the first time that spirit attacked me. In the beginning of my ministry of mercy. Whatever ministry God give us, dear, it's a ministry of mercy. So as we receive mercy, we don't faint. But this spirit, during the time the Lord gave me instructions on what to do, pray for this young man, a cousin in my family that got shot 5 times, point blank range in the head. The Lord told me to go to the hospital and pray for him. And I'm making a long story short. Some of you have heard that testimony. But on my way, my husband was with me. So on our way to go pray for him, I kid you not, something hit me, and I was about to faint. You know, I wasn't fearful or nothing. I felt when this force came on me, and I was about to faint. And I yelled out to God. I said, oh, no, God. Oh, no, God. What good am I to you if I faint? And when I said that, then that spirit had to leave. That spirit left. Then I was able to continue on to go into that room. So there's going to be occasions where that spirit will attack us to prevent us from doing the work of God. But remember, we have this ministry of mercy. So we don't have to faint as long as we look on the inside of us to the one who is greater. That is the Holy Spirit. Verse 2 say, but have renounced the hidden things of dishonesty. You know, that's what we need to do. We need to renounce those things, those wrong things that we have done. Not walking in craftiness, nor handling the word of God deceitfully, but by manifestation of the truth, commending ourselves to every man's conscience in the sight of God. You know, let's be honest. A lot of times that's what caused people to faint, because they're not honest. They have not renounced the hidden things of dishonesty. They're walking in craftiness, being disobedient to God, using his word, you know, to hurt people with. Now, that's wrong, dear heart. 3 say, but if our gospel be hid, it is hid to them that are lost. Yeah, if the gospel is hid to a person, it's only hid to them that are lost. Ain't you so glad that Jesus found us? Found us just in time. So the gospel is not hid to us. We know the truth. You know, we are only held liable to the truth that we know. That's the reason why if God has revealed truth to us, you may see another brother or sister who may be doing the opposite, and you wonder, well, it looks like they're getting away with it. And that's because God has not revealed that truth to them. Remember, if the gospel be hid, it's hid to them that are lost. 4 say, in whom the God of this world hath blinded the minds of them which believe not. See, Satan, the one who blinds the minds of people that don't believe. Sad to say, he's blinding the mind of even God's dear children who don't believe truth. They don't believe truth. The truth, the deep things of God is hidden from them. Satan blind their mind. And Satan blind them because Satan don't want them to see the light of the glorious gospel. Because if they see the light of the glorious gospel of Christ, they will believe. Again, it says, lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine upon them. God shined upon us. Glory to his holy name. So, it just shows you and I, not everyone is going to accept truth. We shouldn't get discouraged, shouldn't faint when one has rejected truth. Because again, there are those who Satan has blinded their mind. Satan don't want them to see the truth. If they see the truth, they're going to come to the glorious light. 5 say, for we preach not ourselves, but Jesus Christ, the Lord, and ourselves your servant for Jesus' sake. See, a true minister of the gospel do not preach about themselves, do not talk about themselves, not even their ministry. It's all about Jesus Christ. It's about Jesus Christ. And also, when we do mention ourselves, we mention ourselves as a servant for Jesus' sake, as Jesus' servant. That's how you know true ministers of the gospel. They don't preach about themselves. They always preach about Jesus Christ. It's always about Jesus Christ. Remember, the Holy Spirit only testifies of Jesus Christ. He don't even bring attention to himself. He testifies of Jesus Christ. And a true minister of the gospel testifies of Jesus Christ. A true child of God don't even talk about themselves. Talk about Jesus and him crucified. Always talk about the goodness of God. Verse 6 says, for God, who commanded the light to shine out of darkness, has shined in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. See, it's God who shares abroad in our heart the light of God. He's the one make us aware of Jesus Christ, God the Father, to the glory of God. Praise his holy name. That's the reason why when light is in you, Jesus said, I am the light. Again, your conversations will only reflect the true light, who is Jesus Christ. Because that's who you are. That's who we are. That's who we are. Remember, we have this treasure in earthen vessels. Mighty treasure. Verse 7 saying, but we have this treasure in earthen vessels, that the excellency of the power may be of God and not of us. And that's a treasure in earthen vessels. The excellency of the power of God in us. Praise his holy name. The power may be of God and not of us. That power don't come from us. It comes from God. That's why every child of God, when we open our mouth, power. Holy Ghost power. Holy Ghost power. So powerful that when you open your mouth and you begin to speak, and a person is not of God, they'll feel that power. And there will be a change. Praise the living God. That's the reason why when you got friends before you became saved, and they still your friends, you be around them, and this treasure in your earthen vessel, which is the power of God, they ain't gonna be a sin alone. Praise the holy his holy name, because of the power of God that is in you. Now, if that's not happening, that means the darkness in them has succumbed the power in you. Lord said, be it according to your faith. Holy Spirit works in us according to the power in us. 8 say, we are troubled on every side. On every side there is trouble. Yet, we're not distressed. We're not worried. Regardless of the trouble on every side. Why? Because of the power of God in us. Say, we are perplexed, but not in despair. We don't understand what's going on, but we're not in despair. Why? Because of the power that works in us, the Holy Ghost. We are persecuted, but not forsaken. Persecuted. We ain't worried, because we know the Lord has not left us. He has not forsaken us. We believe his word. We are cast down, but not destroyed. No, we get up. And we go do it again. Start over again. We're not destroyed. 10 say, always bearing about in the body the dying of the Lord Jesus, that the life also of Jesus might be made manifest in our body. See, we have to also experience his death, dear heart, in our body. Because our body is his body. So we have to experience his dying. His dying on the cross. We have to experience that. So that that his life might be made manifest also in our body. Glory to his holy name. 11 say, for we which live are always delivered unto death for Jesus' sake, that the life also of Jesus might be made manifest in our mortal flesh. See, we have to die. We have to die. This is a spiritual death. We have to die to our wants, to our ambitions in life, to our desire. It's not our will to be done. It's the Father's will to be done. So that means that there's going to be a death, and it's going to hurt. It's going to hurt. It's not going to make us feel good. But we must go through it so that we also experience the life of Jesus. So that the life of Jesus be made manifest in our mortal body, in our mortal flesh. 12 says, so then death works in us, but life in you. So then death works in us, but life in you. You know, we must die. Spiritually die so that others will have life. Praise his holy name. Those who have given themselves to the Lord Jesus Christ have this ministry of mercy and grace. We must die That's why sometimes we just feel like we don't belong. We just feel like, we really feel like we're dying. That's because we are. This is a spiritual death. We are dying so that we may live in Christ, so that others will see our good works in Christ, so that they may live. Greater love than no man that give his life for his brother or his sister. Not only do that mean physically, that means spiritually as well. When the Holy Ghost let us know things are wrong, like wearing the false hair, the false thing, you know, that's a death. We must die. We must be obedient. We must die. Why? So others may see us and that others may live through our death in Christ. Praise his holy name. 13, we having the same spirit of faith, according as it is written, I believed, and therefore have I spoken. See, when you truly believe the word of God, you will speak what you believe. We also believe and therefore speak. See, a person, well, I believe, but you never hear them speaking the truth. So if you truly believe, then you will speak it. You will speak what you believe. 14, knowing that he which raised up the Lord Jesus shall raise us up also by Jesus with you. So we believe that one day the Father will send Jesus back here on earth, and we will be raised up just like Jesus. Do away with this mortal body and put on a body of immortality. So if we believe it, we will speak it. Praise his holy name. And the Father shall present us as a gift to Jesus Christ. Behold, that's a glorious day. Treasure in earthen vessels. That is the Holy Ghost in us. Now, we can do nothing without him. But we can do everything with him. Verse 15, for all things are for your sakes, that the abundant grace might, through the thanksgiving of many, redound to the glory of God. The abundant grace given of many redound to the glory of God. 16, for which cause we faint not. See, we know this truth. That's why we don't faint. We don't get discouraged. We don't get in despair because we know truth. For this cause we faint not. But though our outward man perish, now this human body may slowly be deteriorating, yet the inward man on the inside is renewed day by day. It's being renewed day by day. So, because of this, we faint not. Our hope is in Christ Jesus. And that's why we always look ahead to that prize, to the high calling. I tell you, dear heart, we don't faint. We don't give up. You know, you may have heard me give this testimony, but I remember as a young girl, I was reading the scripture. You know, I would read scripture and memorize scripture, but the scripture wasn't in me. You know, there's a lot of stuff spiritually I hadn't experienced yet. I haven't had that spiritual experience, you know, that the Lord wanted me to have. So the Lord was, through this dream, he was telling me, Tab, you have to go through a spiritual experience. I'm going to take you through a spiritual experience, and it's gonna happen years. It's going to last for years and years and years and years and years so that my word will get deeply rooted on the inside of you and the devil cannot uproot it. So I said, yes, Lord, just help me accept the way that you does it. Because he's the author, he's the finisher of our faith, dear Lord. He knows what it's going to take in between to perfect our trust, our faith. There's one thing to memorize scripture. but another thing to know scripture on the inside through it. So I remember he put me in this dream. And in this dream, I was in an ocean, sea. And I'm on top of the water swimming, trying to get to my destination. And as I looked up, I saw this city afar off. So I knew my destination was to get to that city. If I could just make it to that city, I would be all right. But the current was so strong, but I was determined to make it to that city. And I, you know, kept swimming. And every now and then I look up over my eyes and I see that city. And then I woke up. You know, I show you when the Lord gives you a dream, you don't have to go around asking for interpretation, because the Holy Ghost will immediately give you that interpretation. So the Lord gave me that interpretation. He let me know. He said, Terry, you started out on this journey, but there's going to be storms in your life, and you're gonna continue the toward that goal, but it's going to be very difficult. Because truthfully, in the dream, I don't know if I made it or not. That's why the Lord said, one that endures to the end shall be saved. And you can store it out, but you can drop out. So he was sharing that with me about the storms of life. That represent the storms of life. But as long as I kept my eyes on that city, and you know, to reach that destination, kept trying and not faint, you know, I could make it. But again, I couldn't tell you if I made it or not. But again, like I said, every now and then I would look and see that city, and I would go toward that city. So we're going to have storms of life, and storms of life, but we should not faint. Remember now, you know, the outward man may be weak. And I get great encouragement in God's word when he tells us that his strength is made perfect in our weakness. So I don't focus on my weakness. I focus on his strength. He gives me his strength to endure and bear all things. Though my outward man perish, yet my inward man is renewed day by day by trusting in the Lord's strength. Team say, for our light affliction. You know, the Lord said our affliction is very light. And it is. It's very light. You know, the heaviness of affliction was put on the body of Jesus Christ on the cross. So therefore, what we are experiencing actually is a light, L-I-G-H-T, affliction, which is but for a moment. And it worketh for us a far more exceeding an eternal weight of glory. Praise the living God. So we rejoice in affliction, because we depend on the greater one on the inside of us, who is the Holy Spirit. We can do all things through him. He give us the strength to endure and bear all things. You know, if you have to cry out, cry out. Praise the Lord, you're crying out to God for help. Praise the living God. Verse 18 says, while we look not at the things which are seen. You know, we don't look at the things that are seen, but at the things which are not seen. For the things which are seen, they are temporal. Everything that we see is temporary. But the things which are not seen are eternal. So we look at eternal things, things that are not seen. We walk by faith, not by sight, not by our feeling. Praise the living God. Because the things which are not seen are eternal. Before we have this treasure in earthen vessels, the Holy Ghost in us, that's who we need. You know, when the Father comes back here, he gonna look for that earnest expectation, that down payment. And that down payment is the Holy Spirit on the inside of us. You know what a down payment is? You know, you right now you can't afford to purchase an item, so it allow you to put a down, put in layaway, put that down payment on it, but it's yours. And so when you finish paying for it, you can get it. But the Holy Spirit is God's down payment. If we don't have the Holy Spirit in us, we are not even God. We're not of God. We're not God's child. Okay, how much a person say they love God, God loves them. If they don't have the Holy Spirit in them, you don't belong to God. Praise his holy name. So this treasure in earthen vessels, that treasure is the Holy Spirit. And, you know, please, Holy Spirit, don't leave me. Don't walk away from it, from me. Don't grieve him, dear Lord. And I'll never forget, again, first time I experienced the Holy Spirit, who is actually Jesus Christ's spirit, walking away from a person. Just literally walked away. Now, I didn't see a person, but I could present just walk away from this person. And I looked, I was standing there looking like an idiot. Finally, I said, well, Holy Spirit, you left. What can I do? I can't do nothing. So I just left, too. I learned that, dear Lord. Don't grieve him. You know, demon is only afraid of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is God on earth. Emmanuel, God on earth. Jesus still on earth by his Spirit. Why do you think the devil works so hard to keep the Holy Spirit out of churches? Because the Holy Spirit come in your church. He's cleaning house. Come into your body, he's cleaning house. But don't grieve him. Don't grieve him. When the Holy Spirit tell us to do something, we do it. He tell us not to do something, don't do it. Obey him. He ain't going to force you. Demon will force you to do that will. Holy Spirit will not. He will not force you. He'll lead and guide you in a path of righteousness. And it's up to you to obey. He's not going to force you. We need him. Because he truly is the treasure. And we are the vessel on this earth that he dwells in. Praise the living God. Father, we thank you for your word today. You are awesome. We just thank you for the love you have for us. You never leave us. You never forsake us. Thank you for the precious gift of your Holy Spirit. He was sent to us on the day of Pentecost. He's been here ever since. Father, we just thank you for your love and your affection. We thank you too, Jesus, for sacrificing your life for us. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen, amen, amen. Praise the living God. Dear Lord, thank you for joining me today on Holy Ghost Fire Talk. You can join this live broadcast on Monday and Fridays at 12 noon Eastern Standard Time. And also remember Shalom Morning Prayer. We're starting back on Tuesdays at 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time as well. Come and listen to the Holy Spirit talk to you. Glory to his holy name. So I see I do have one caller on the line that joined me live. And I want to thank you for your encouragement for joining in live. As promised, in calling, I will bring you on to see if you have any questions pertaining to the message. If not, just say thank you. I don't have any questions. So I'm going to unmute VO902 and ask, hold on, if you have any questions. Do you have any questions pertaining to the message?
Hi, Evangelist. How are you doing?
And it's
hello.
Lisa, my sister Lisa. Thank you
yes,
for your faithfulness, Lisa. So
encouraging. Oh, yes. I enjoy hearing the word on Mondays and Fridays. I enjoy it, really. So whenever I get an opportunity to get the word, you know, I come.
yeah. Do you get a chance to speak to Evangelist King at the end of the message? And I have some people say, yeah, Evangelist, I'm glad you're back. I'm glad you're back for Holy Ghost Fire Talk. I said, okay. Let me see if you're going to join me on the live broadcast.
Well, it's, yeah, he is.
You show me your faith by your words, not by your
yes,
talk.
Man.
not by your texts, T-E-X-T-S, but by your works. Show me your faith by your works. So I thank God for you. You know, it's a great sacrifice for me to do these Levi broadcasts, and I promise the Lord that starting that this year, I'm going to let that be live broadcast. Whenever I have the strength, I'm going to do it. So praise the living God. You know, right now, they're under 30 minutes, but as I continue, then it'll probably end up being an hour. Because you know, my circumstances have changed. You know that means that my circumstances have changed. So I don't have my private office like I used to have. So that limits me. But praise God. Anyway, Shalom Morning Prayer will be tomorrow at 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. What I do, I bring the light teaching and people call in. I bring you on, join me for corporate prayer. If you're at work, then you can just mute yourself. Mute yourself if you're at work, you know, and just pray the spirit within yourself, okay? All right, my dear sister, look forward to you coming to the house again one day.
I don't know if it's, you know, I want to come down all the time, but I don't want to get on your nerves.
I let you know if that's a good time. Okay, Lisa.
Okay. Thank you.
All right. Praise God. Amen. She is so free. She's right. She will come all the time, and I don't blame her. You know, probably eventually, you know, when the Lord allowed us to move out of this place, if we would do another place, and maybe that can happen. But anyway, dear heart, join me tomorrow on Shalom Morning Prayer, 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. To join the host, just go to the website, thechildrensmic.org/radio, and you find instructions on how to join the host, okay? All right, now, everybody, you stay blessed in Jesus' mighty name. Shalom.